every day when I wake up. I can see his mercies all around me, and in every circumstance, his plans for me is to
grace and peace and good morning to each and every one of you. Welcome to First Start. Once again, God has favored us with his grace and with his mercy by blessing us with a brand new day. Lamentations chapter number 3, verse 23 says that the mercies of God are renewed every single morning. Great is his faithfulness to you and I. Let me take a moment and greet not only the members of our church, but those who watch faithfully around this country and abroad. Thank you so much for connecting. Thank you so much for being a part of this morning devotion. I want to ask you again, keep sharing this because I believe it's going to be a blessing to others, because I believe it is being a blessing to you. We have been talking, as you know, on the subject for several weeks now of faith, on the subject rather of faith. And on yesterday, we went to Isaiah chapter number 55. And what we're going to do is understand how the confession of our faith actually works. And so go to Isaiah again, chapter number 55, verses 8 through 11. He is recording the words of our Lord, and he says, "For my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are your ways my ways, saith the Lord." So we're now clear on who's talking. "For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. For as the rain cometh down from heaven, and snow from heaven, and returneth not thither, but watereth the earth, and maketh it bring forth and bud, that it may give seed to the sower, bread to the eater. So shall my word be that goeth forth out of my mouth. It shall not return unto me void, but it shall accomplish that which I please, and it shall prosper in the thing whereto I sent it." Again, we are very clear that God is speaking, and Isaiah the prophet is recording what God is saying. One of the first things that we understand about confession is that what we are confessing is not coming from the bottom up, but rather the top down. I want to say that again. What I'm going to confess as a part of my walk of faith, it will not originate in the earth. It will originate in heaven. In other words, I'm going to have to discover what heaven has said about my earthly situation. I'm going to have to understand what God is speaking concerning my situation. And as I discover what God is saying, I need to say not what I want, but I need to say what he has already determined for my life. No wonder when Jesus teaches in the New Testament on the subject of prayer, he says that we should pray that God's will would be done in earth as it is in heaven. And this is very crucial, because if you look at this particular passage of scripture, I want to show you something here. God says, "My thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are my ways. My thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are your ways my ways, saith the Lord. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts." One of the things that I want us to be very clear on is when I am confessing God's word as a part of my faith journey, if what I am saying about what I want is just originating from an earthly place or from a carnal place or from a fleshly desire or a fleshly focus, and I'm not understanding what heaven has already determined about my situation, it is highly likely that I am going to say something that is different than what God has already determined. If I am just confessing my own desires, what I want, what I wish, what I really want God to do, what I am going to often do is say something that is different than what God has already determined about my life. You say, well, Bishop, how can you say that? Because again, if you look at this passage of scripture, God says, my thoughts are not your thoughts. And how I do what I do is different than how you do what you do. And here's the distance, make a note of this, here is the distance between the intellect. It is found in the definition of the word heavens. It is found in the word heaven. In other words, when you define, make a note of this, the word heaven, as far as the heavens are above the earth, that's how far his ways are from my ways and his thoughts from my thoughts. So generally, if I'm just going to see and speak what I want, it's probably going to be different than what God has already determined. And so for those that are taking notes, I want you to consider that the word heaven in this particular passage of scripture, it is defined with two words. Number one, the abode of the stars or atmosphere. The abode of the stars or atmosphere. And here's what I want us to understand. The nearest star is almost 6 trillion miles away. The nearest star from planet Earth is almost 6 trillion miles away. If you were to walk to the nearest star, it would take you 950 million years to get there. All right. So heaven is defined as the place where the stars dwell. And the nearest star is about 6 trillion miles away. But it is also determined by atmosphere. And the atmosphere is the gases or are the gases. Is the gas, are the gases? It is the gas that surrounds planet Earth. And in those gases that surround, if you look at pictures of planet Earth from space, sometimes you'll see that blue haze around the planet. That's considered the atmosphere. And the atmosphere is close to, let me make sure I get this, close to 6,000 miles in the air. From Earth to the atmosphere, about 6,000 miles in the air. I want to make sure that I say this correctly. And so when it comes to how God thinks and how I think, there's a great distance between the two. So this is why in prayer and in study of the Word of God, I've got to determine what God has already said about my earthly situation and then began to say what God says about my life. Why? Because his thoughts are not my thoughts. I know what I want, but I need to discover what he wants for me concerning this situation. I know what I desire, but I need to figure out what he has already desired and designed for my life concerning this particular area. And there are two notable ways as I close that you and I can discover that in prayer and in the Word of God. Make a note of that. In prayer and in the Word of God. So let me challenge you today. Whatever it is that you are praying for or you're in faith for, I want you to spend some time in prayer. Spend some time in the Word of God. Because as we spend time in prayer and in the Word of God, we will discover what God has already determined about his concerning our life, rather, we'll discover what he's already determined about our lives, and we'll determine his will for our lives based upon his word. Let me stop here. I'm way over time. God willing, I will see you in the morning. God bless. God, there's a God that loves you.